if people are stuck and they're not moving forwards, for me, it's obvious. It's you're thinking in your mentality. It's either you don't believe it, you've got a fear of failure, a fear of rejection, a fear of success. Now, all of these negative emotions that you experience, you have to include them on the journey to get to where you want to get to. And a lot of people don't say that.
Hey there, this is Neil Napier and welcome to this podcast of MyFirst1000. Today, I'm joined by Ryan Phillips. Ryan is the CEO and a co-founder of a company called VideoSuite, and they help entrepreneurs and marketers increase their income and their impact using the power of videos. Now, I have to say that I have used a lot of products that Ryan has done before, but what I haven't seen from Ryan too much myself is courses, but I know that he's still crushing it with them. So hey, Ryan, welcome to this session with us today.
Hey, Neil, thanks for inviting me on. And if we can share some things that are going to help some people that are listening to this, then that's going to be great. So happy to help out and offer as much value as I can.
I appreciate that very much. So Ryan, can you tell us a little bit about your business? What do you do at the moment?
Yes, sure. So our kind of core company is called VideoSuite, and we create video software. So right now, we've got three products. We've got one video software that creates video ads. So the problem that solves, people that want to sell more courses or sell more of their services, one of the best traffic channels is Facebook ads, YouTube ads. And the challenge that a lot of people have is creating the videos for them. So that's what one of our software does. Our other software is called Interactor, and that's an interactive video platform. So that basically helps people convert more leads and make more sales using video. Then our third product is a course called Local Video Academy. So this is a video course that teaches people how to go out. It doesn't really have to be their local area. It can be anywhere, but it teaches them to go to local businesses and helps local businesses by providing them leads. That's what local businesses want at the end of the day. They want more leads and more customers. So we teach people to go out from scratch, how to approach businesses, how to take them on as clients, and basically provide lead gen service for them and get paid recurring monthly. And that's our main course right now. With that course, we partnered with one of our business partners, Brandon Lucero, who's a ninja at that. And that's the information product that we've got right now.
So let's talk about partnering for a second, because that's something that you just talked about. And a lot of people who are watching this, they usually think that the only way they can sell a product, a course, a membership site, is if they create it. But it doesn't have to be just like that, right? They could also partner with someone who has the expertise.
Correct. So, and I think that's the biggest challenge and the biggest stumbling block that I see people come into. They think that, you know, if I'm going to create an information product, this is one of the problems that I had when I first started. I thought I had to become the expert, you know, get results in that space before then I can create a course or a product and then sell it. But it doesn't have to be that way. For example, I'll give you three quick examples. So one is me at the minute. We had a lot of customers that would use our video software. And what a lot of them was doing, what we found, was they was using our video software and selling the video ads or the interactive videos to businesses. So we thought, how can we serve and add value to those more? And it was to actually get them or create the best course that's going to help them create recurring income and actually sell to local businesses. Now, we didn't have the expertise in that. So we had two choices. We could either, one, go out, you know, by trial and error, go out and learn how to do that, then put a course together and then give it to our users. Would that offer them the most value? Probably not. Would it stroke like my ego? Probably it would, because then I'd be the expert again. But you know, it's not about that. So we went on a bit of a search. We found the best person in the world that uses video and video ads to get leads for local businesses. Approached him, put a deal together, partnered, and now we're doing incredibly well selling that. Another example: one of my good friends actually does graphics for our company, Jordan. I've known him since I was a little kid. I used to teach him martial arts. Okay. he was doing graphics for our company, for our sales pages, things like that. And thought, you know, I'd love to be able to do, because we call him the free spirit. He used to be a graphic designer. Then he started just teaching martial arts a little bit, and he's here, there, and everywhere, basically. So I showed him how to create a course. Now, mm-hmm. a few months later, he's making £6,000 per month recurring revenue, growing every single month, teaching martial arts tricks, which are the fancy jump kicks and tricks. Now, wow. he isn't the expert. So this is the best thing. He's partnered with one of his friends in that space called Kojo, who had a bit of a following already. People, you know, young kids would follow him, jumping kicks, somersaults, and all of that stuff. So Jordan put the membership site together, put the video together. So now Jordan's pretty much hands off, probably works an hour or two a week. He gets half of that income, but it's a £3,000 a month full-time income from working like an hour a week or whatever. Final example that I'll share. My mentor, or one of my mentors, Alex Becker. That's why I'm actually in New York now. This is the hotel room in New York. Okay. Square is actually right behind me. And
I think I can tell everyone that the laptop is right now sitting on the ironboard, just so people know.
Exactly. So here we go. There's the ironing board. And that's a big skyscraper. And down that there is Times Square.
So that's the New York lifestyle.
Exactly. And I'm here for a mastermind with my mentor, Alex Becker. He's doing multiple seven figures per month selling a course, courses on e-commerce, and he's not the expert with that. He's partnered with two people, Devin Zander and Matt Schmidt, who created the course because they're the experts. Alex isn't. I'm not the expert with local video. Jordan's a bit of an example because he can do all the crazy flips and tricks. So he's a bit of an expert, but you don't have to be the person that, you know, you could partner with someone in any niche. You just do the marketing, you know, put together the membership site, and then you're good to go. We're doing over six figures a month doing that just with our information product when we're not the expert. Alex is doing seven figures. Jordan working, you know, a couple of hours a week max, and he's doing, you know, thousands of pounds, about $10,000 per month, £6,000 a month. With the partner that he's got.
This is interesting. And I must say that before I go on the call with you, I didn't expect that we'll talk about this, but I want to go a little bit deeper here. So let's say if someone's watching this and they feel inspired already, they feel like, okay, I don't have the expertise in a certain thing, but I can do pretty well with marketing. I can talk to people. How do they convince someone who has the expertise? What would it take? Like, what would it take for you to go up to someone and say, hey, let's do something together?
So, again, sometimes it can be a bit of a numbers game. All I did, I said to my mentor, I said, Alex, how did you get Devin on to do the HeroCom 2020 product? He said, I approached him by saying this. I just basically copy and pasted it. So basically, I copy and pasted the message, changed out the product name. I basically went to Brandon and said, look, I think we can, if we come together and put a course together, I think that we can get it to X amount of dollars per day. I'll happily create the sales material, you know, put the sales, the marketing materials together. We'll pay for the paid traffic. We'll give you a percentage of net profits. Are you happy to do it? Then also, and this is one of the things as well, you want to make it a no-brainer deal. Just like when you're selling something, you want to make it a no-brainer deal. So we said to Brandon, and look, we'll put all that together. We'll create the sales material, make the marketing material, we'll start running the paid traffic before you even create the course. And then wow. if we don't get the take up, then we'll just refund those customers. You don't have to, because their only challenge, if you think about it from the course creator's point of view, is their time investment. So that's all they're investing. They're just investing the time to create that course. So if you can take away that pain, same with marketing sales, you can handle that objection before it even comes up. It becomes a no-brainer offer. It just so happens though, Brandon already had a course and we edited that stuff together. And then ran with it. Same with Jordan. Jordan just, the thing with Kojo, this is the martial arts guy that my friend Jordan has created the course with. Kojo was getting messages on his Instagram saying, hey, can you give us private like Skype coaching? And he had like, I think 9 students he was doing private Skype calls with to help them with the martial arts kicks and stuff. So it was already kind of like proof of concept right there. So Jordan just said, hey, instead of you going on Skype and doing this, he took the pain away as well. That was Kojo's pain, the time and energy to stop doing what he was doing and having to be like strict and I'm on Skype with this person one-on-one. It's like him teaching a class. That's not what he wanted to do. He just wanted to jump around, flip and trick and train. And that's all. That was his biggest passion. So Jordan went and approached him, said, look, instead of you doing that, I can put together this membership site. I'll build it all. I'll do everything. And then you can just tell people, hey, we're partnering. We've got this. It's only, you know, he charges, he's got four different levels, but 90% of his members pay £9.99 a month. It's only low ticket. He's got loads of people in there. And he said, look, if it doesn't work out, you can go back to, you know, your stuff. No loss wasted. It's just my time and I'll build it all out. Took him 30 days to build out, you know, the membership site, the sales page. I was just giving him a couple of tips on that. And then he was off to the races. They launched it, got it to, I think it was £4,000 a month straight away. Because his goal was £2,000 a month to replace his full-time income as a graphic designer. Hit that, and then it's just growing every month. No paid traffic. In fact, when I get back from New York, he's coming around mine, and we're going to start doing Facebook ads, retargeting, YouTube ads. I think he'll get to 10 grand a month in the next couple of months. And it's insane. Martial arts tricking, jumps, kicks, and flips. You wouldn't think it's possible. But, you know, for anyone that is thinking, I've not got the expertise, maybe I'm willing to put the time and energy in to learn something so then I can add value and start a course or a product, you know, it might be a better idea to shortcut that time to just go and reach out to people, partner with people. Like, there's people in my hometown, Burton-on-Trent. It's a tiny town, 60,000 people. There's a guy that's got, he's just in great shape. And I was thinking, I'm not now because I'm focused on this one product, but I know I could easily go to him. He's got a bit of an Instagram following already. I think he's got like 10, 11,000 followers. Knows nothing about courses. I could easily put together a membership site, get him to make a few videos at the gym, and I think we could get that to a few grand a month straight away. There's another a girl that I know in the same city who's into makeup and everything. And I know that the makeup and beauty niche is massive. I know a friend actually who's got his fiance has got a recurring revenue of like £7,000 a month, charging £9.99 a month for people how to like do the makeup and stuff. Like, if you can partner with someone that's got an expertise, 9 times out of 10, they won't care about marketing and sales. They probably hate marketing and sales. And that's how I got my partner for our software company. He hates marketing and sales, loves creating software. So if you can come with the marketing sales and approach them with an opportunity that's no risk, then, you know, you're highly likely to be able to at least put it out there into the market and test it.
That's incredible. And I got to say, a few £1,000, dollars or euros could be life-changing for a lot of people. So I'm sure that they'd be happy to let, you know, you handle the marketing and sales side of things, and they just remain to be the experts if that's not what you want. But let me ask you this. You said you're doing six figures a month, more or less, with your course offer at the moment. How difficult was it to make your first sale there or make your first $1,000?
So the six figures a month that we're doing, that was just with the course and stuff. We're doing less than that with our software. We're still doing multiple tens of thousands a month with the software stuff. But with the actual course, that's been our main focus. Because what we're doing is we're using the course, the information product, to bring people in as new customers to then get them on our software. That's what our model is or whatever. So all of our kind of, for the last couple of months, all of our marketing, all of our focus in the company has been, how can we get this webinar out that's going to sell this information product to loads of different people? And the reason why we do that is because an information product can be, or a course can be sexy. It can, you know, how you can market it is a lot easier than marketing software a lot of the time. Sure. And that's why we're doing that. For my first $1,000, I made my first $1,000 in 1 week with my very first information product about 4 or 5 years ago, and that was called Elite Smartphone Video. And how that come about, that, you know, I'll tell you a quick story. And by the way, this is before a year of like failing at doing stuff, by the way. And I was in the weight loss space. I had a book called The Rapid Fat Loss Diet, and I'd make a couple of sales here and there. And again, for people thinking, I can't create a course, I'm not the expert, but for the Rapid Fat Loss Diet, I read Tim Ferriss's book, The 4-Hour Work Week, and then I thought, this book's awesome. I'm going to create a product like that and sell it. I know I can't copy it, but I know that I can model it. So then what I did is I bought the two best-selling diet products at the time. One was called, and these are just the two best-selling diet products on ClickBank, Beyond Diet and The Truth About Six-Pack Abs. Took the best bits out of all three of those books, put a little chapter in about mindset, so that's what I'm into, and created the Rapid Fat Loss Diet. I was struggling to sell that, although I was selling it profitably on Facebook, but I couldn't scale it up to the numbers that I wanted. So what I decided I decided, right, screw this. I don't want to sell this for a low ticket price. I'm going to do one-on-one weight loss coaching. Because that was like the in thing in marketing at the time. Yeah, you want to do high ticket coaching. So I thought, right, I'll do that then. And I thought, how I'm positioned at the minute, no one's going to pay me for high ticket weight loss coaching. So I thought I'll create some videos that will position me as the expert. And then I can make like an indoctrination sequence and some marketing, put that together to help people, that would convince people to pay me money because I know that I can help people lose weight. So that was my grand plan. That was my scheme. And I was making these cool videos with my iPhone because I couldn't afford, at the time, I couldn't afford a decent camera. So I was trying to make these like professional, like really slick videos with my iPhone. And one of my friends, my accountability partner at the time, said, hey, those videos are awesome. How did you make them? Because I was showing him what I was up to. He was telling me what he was up to, was helping each other. And I said, I just made them with my phone because I can't afford a camera. So he was like, hey, do you want to put a product together and launch it? And I was like, yeah, okay then. Like, the worst that can happen is we're going to learn a ton. So we put together some sales material. It was the worst thing you've ever seen. Like, it was just embarrassing. I've still got the pages up now so I can show people, which is quite funny. Mm-hmm. Elite smartphone video. And we did $8,000 in a week when we sold it. Half of that went to like our affiliates and joint venture partners. So me and Nick Farina was my accountability partner at the time. We had about $4,000. We split that between us. So I remember making $2,000 net profit in that week. And I was like, holy shit, this is the best thing ever. Like, and then I thought, screw this weight loss stuff. I'm just going to do things with video. And that's kind of progressed into making video software now.
Got it. And I must say, a lot of people need it. So you're definitely filling in a big gap in the market, a big knowledge gap and a big software gap as well. So that's really good. Now, I want to ask you this, and I must say, I must tell everyone that I know you personally, we've met before, right? So people's lives change when they hit their first $1,000 and they grow and they scale up. And I know you, so I've seen the way you dress. I mean, it's very plain, simple clothes. That's not what you're after. But how has your lifestyle changed over time as you've become more successful? What have you gotten into? I know you maybe got something to show.
Oh, so yeah, there's a couple of things here, and I think a really important lesson that I've learned. So the thing that my first $1,000, when I made that making courses, the thing about that is it gave me the belief that, holy crap, I can go and I can do this. And like, I've made, not even that I took $2,000 as my net profit for the first time, we made $8,000. Like, we can go on and we know we've done a ton of stuff wrong. How much can we make the next time? It gives you that spark, kind of relights the fire for you to push mm-hmm. forward. So I think that's really important. And how, like, from where we was, or where I was back then to now, you know, we got a seven-figure software company. The change really for me isn't in the things that you get. So I know you was hinting at my, I got this a Rolex Day-Date 118238. It's my dream watch. And I bought this. As it wasn't actually a business milestone, but it was like a personal financial milestone. Mm-hmm. One of my main focuses has been more being better managing money and finances, and that's what this watch celebrates. And also like having like a supercar or building my own house, like all these things that are going on. You people don't realize it when you're not at that place, because I didn't. I thought that would be the be all and end all, and that'd be really cool. But really, it doesn't change a freaking thing. Like this watch tells the time the same as, you know, the iPhone watches. The house that I'm going to be moving into, that's going to be built in December, I've like, it's not going to be much different to where I'm living now. The car that I drive isn't much, like, it does all the same stuff. But for me, the important thing is, the reason why I started an online business was my highest values are adventure, excitement, growth, and contribution. So what the money that comes from adding value, putting a course out there, you know, how your life changes, it just means that you can live on your terms, how you want, doing the things that you want to do. So like I said, adventure, excitement, growth, and contribution. Adventure and excitement. Like, I'm in New York now. I was in Dublin last month. I was in Venice, Italy with you the month after. Next month, in August, I said, I'm not going away anywhere. I'm going to get my head down and do some work. But then September, I'll be in Rome. I'm taking my brother to Rome for his birthday. He probably won't watch this interview because it's going to be a surprise. Hopefully he doesn't. October, I'll be in London. And then I'll be in Portugal, another marketing event. it's like December, the new house is getting created. So all the success does and how your life changes, it means that you can actualize your values and you can do the things that you want to do a lot better. Because that's all that money does. It just gives you more, it gives you more security and it gives you more freedom to do the things that you want to do, spend the money on you want to do, whether that's to help your friends and family, travel the world, to live in a house, get a supercar, you know, whatever the thing is that you want to do, it just helps you do that. And that's what I'd say the main thing that has changed about my life. It just means that I can actualize those values of adventure, excitement, growth and contribution a lot better and a lot easier than if I was broke, working a job that I hated and had no energy like where I was at before.
I think it's a good point, and I wish a lot of people would listen to this and also internalize this, that whatever money you make, it's really to keep score at the end of the day and to actualize the values that you want to live your life by. So if you want a bigger house, and you know that's probably because you want comfort in life, so do whatever you can to get to that level where you're comfortable. But I will say this, because I know we've had talks about where we are at right now and where we want to go to. 5 years ago, we looked at this figure, this lifestyle, and we thought, well, you know, once we get this, this is it. And now that we're here, we're like, well, you know, once we get there, that is it. And that's not us being greedy. That's us just realizing there's more in life. And as long as our basic needs, our values are met, then we can do more and more. And, you know, a lot of that goes back to the society, your family, like you said, you're taking your brother to Rome. And a lot of it helps to just keep you going, moving forward as well.
So, 100%. I think like, it's he's not the richest man in the world, but some people call him, you know, the best investor, Warren Buffett. Like he wears like normal clothes, lives in a normal house, drives like a normal car. He could have anything in the world that he wanted, but that's not what he's about. It's not where his values and where his intentions are. And yeah, like you say, if people can internalize that and not get caught up in the whole, oh, I've got to get this and got to get that and got to get that, then I think you'll be a lot more happy and fulfilled, and you'll be a lot more successful as well.
Absolutely. So let's do a quick fire round, because I've got a few questions to ask you. The very first thing is, what's your favorite book or what are you reading at the moment?
Okay. In fact, seeing as though it's just right here. So this is, I've not actually started it, but the book that I'm going to be reading, and this is what Sam Ovens, he does, he just sells courses. And he does multiple seven figures per month. He's going to be here on Saturday speaking. So I'm looking forward to him. And he said that if you've not read this book as a businessman, you're irresponsible. And it's Made in America by Sam Walton. So this is what I'm going to be reading on the flight on the way home. But for me personally, the best books that I can recommend, there's two. One is The 4-Hour Work Week. That was really one of the catalysts that made me start my entrepreneurial journey. And the other is The Richest Man in Babylon, because that really gives you some sound financial advice. And it covers a boring topic in a really exciting way. It's a short book. It's like it's story-based. And yeah, that's one of the best books I've ever read.
Sure. I'll check both of them out. And the one that you showed as well, of course. Next question is, what kind of music are you into and what's your favorite band these days?
I'm into all types of music. I'm actually, one of my passions is dance. I do breakdance. I've been doing breakdance for the last 15 years. So I love hip hop. I love rap. I also love cheesy, you know, sing-along music. I love like Bon Jovi, Queen, Bryan Adams. I love Ed Sheeran. I love pop music. So honestly, I love all different types of music. But my favorite song in the world ever, and I always categorize this as the song that if you could only listen to it for the rest of your life, what song would you pick? And it would be Mbop by Hanson. Because whenever I hear that, it just makes me dead happy. And that's my favorite song. Ashamed to admit it, but yeah, Mbop by Hanson. Yeah.
Well, don't worry, I'm not going to play it for you now, but that's good to know. next thing, I know you travel a lot, but what's your favorite holiday destination? Is it the city or the beach? Do you like to go to the mountains or forests?
Beach or nature. Like big cities like this, I love visiting for a very, very small amount of time, but it's not me. Like I like being in nature. I think the energy, the frequency is a lot different there. And I like the more chilled, relaxed and being out in nature. So definitely be that.
Okay. And what's your favorite city in the world to travel to?
It's got to be New York. Like when I was driving in, I could see the skyline, the Empire State Building. I was like, I felt a little bit intimidated, really excited. And I was like, this is just completely something that I've never experienced before. Like, it's absolutely incredible.
Cool. No, that's nice. Ryan, one last thing. Well, two things, actually. One, I mean, there are a lot of people that are listening in and they still feel like they want to do stuff, but they feel that they may be stuck. In your opinion, what should be the next step if they feel that they're stuck at, you know, building courses or selling them? What should be one thing they should keep reminding themselves to get results?
For me, and this might, let me try and explain this so you can get your head around, I think it's important. The number one reason for most failure that I've seen people encounter is what I would call the lack of understanding of the law of cause and effect. So what I mean by that is this: there's three things that you need to really focus on to be successful in anything, especially online marketing or selling courses. And that's be, do, and have. Now, most people don't understand that. So be means you have to become. So you need to educate yourself, learn, develop specialized knowledge. You have to be. Then it's do. So you have to take action. You have to implement and execute on what you've learned. And then you get what you get. So it's be, then it's do, then it's have. Now, the reason why I see people don't understand that is if people did, there'd be millions and millions of people successful. And the kind of the way it actually works with us, and the reason why so many people get stuck and they can't move forwards, is because of their thinking and their mindset. So how it kind of translates in, let's say, nature, you have to plant a seed before you get a harvest. Without the seed, there is no harvest. So the seed is the catalyst, if you like. The seed creates this thing at the end, the consequence. Now, how that works with us in regards to business is, and this is what I heard by a guy called George Zalicki, very, very high level thinker. And I'd recommend anyone check out his stuff. And he said, I just heard him say on a CD, and he said, thought is the creative power of circumstance. Now, what that means is, in the nature of your thinking, you create your emotions. Then a combination of your thoughts and emotions make you behave in a certain way. Now, all of that over time, that translates into habitual ways of thinking and reacting, habitual behaviors, i.e. habits. And from those habits and those behaviors, you create your circumstance, which is your life. And that's the order of what it goes down. So it's your thoughts create your emotions. Your thoughts and emotions create your behaviors. Your behaviors over time solidify into habits, i.e. habitual ways of thinking and reacting. And from those habitual ways, you create your life. And you know, this circumstance or your life that you have at the end, it could be anything. It could be your business, your profits, your lack of profits, your health, energy, and vitality, your relationship, whatever it is. But I think it's really important to get clear that the genesis of this circumstance, when you peel back the onion layer far enough, comes down to our attitude of mind. It's our thinking and it's our mindset. So I think that's a big thing that holds people back. What I'd recommend, if people are stuck and they're not moving forwards, for me, it's obvious. It's your thinking and your mentality. It's either you don't believe it, you got a fear of failure, a fear of rejection, a fear of success. You know, all of these negative emotions that you experience, you have to include them on the journey to get to where you want to get to. And a lot of people don't say that. Like, it's quite a popular thing in the business world. They say, you got to hustle and you have to fail forwards fast. And what a lot of people don't say is, when you're on that journey from where you are now to where you want to get to, and you're failing forwards fast, they don't tell you that these negative emotions are going to come on board. And they do. On your journey to success, you are going to feel overwhelmed, frustration, confusion, rejection, feeling of not good enough, jealousy, anger, upset, you know, not worthy. All of these things you are going to experience on your journey to get to where you want to get to. Everyone that's successful, you know, Neil, myself, the other people that are in this series, they've all gone through, experienced those emotions and gone through them. So I think you have to know in advance and be okay in advance that when you're failing forwards fast to get to where you want to get to, these negative emotions are going to happen. Most people, when these negative emotions show up, it knocks them off the path. Hence, there's so many people that start something out, but they don't get to the final destination. They don't get to that, you know, success that they want to get to. So when those negative emotions come on the journey, be okay with it. Understand, you know they're going to come. When they do come, you just accept them and carry on moving. And I think that would be that, those two things, thought and mindset, in regards to knowing how success is created or the circumstance of our life's created, whether it's good or bad right now, it all comes down to your thinking and your mindset, because your thinking creates your emotions, behaviors, and habits. And also, when you're failing forwards fast, getting to where you want to get to, negative emotions are going to show up. Understand they are in advance, be okay with that. So when they do show up, you know, you can accept it and keep moving forwards. It's not going to knock you off the path. I think that they're two really important things, that if you can really get that, then there's no doubt in my mind that you're going to get to where you want to get to, whatever success means for you.
Very cool. I have to say, Ryan, if you get bored of your video business or if you sell it or whatever, go into motivation. I think you'll do a lot of people.
No, thank you so much. I appreciate that. Thank you.
No, it's good. It's. I think that's something I want to kind of get it transcribed after and have it as a separate post somewhere, because I think it could really inspire a lot of people. So thank you. One last thing then. So if people want to learn more about you, where can they go? Do you have a website about you or about your business?
Just social media will be best, because Instagram, my tag on Instagram is Ryan Phillips HQ. Any messages that I got off Instagram, like, my phone's always with me. I personally reply to them. It's not like our support, like if you'd contact us through our support desk or through a contact on our website, and Facebook as well. My Facebook is, I think my personal Facebook's Ryan Phillips Online, and the business Facebook page is Ryan Phillips HQ. But I reply to them. I reply to all the comments on YouTube. So just social media, Ryan Phillips and Ryan Phillips HQ would be the best place to reach out.
Sure. Well, we appreciate that a lot. And I definitely took longer than I said I would. So thanks for sticking with me. And it's been really, really good. I appreciate you being here, Ryan.
No worries at all. I'm about to meet a friend now, go on to one of those open top, hop on, hop off bus tours around the city, ready for the mastermind tomorrow. So excited about that.
Good. Have fun there. But again, thanks for being here.
No worries. Thanks for the invitation. See you later.
Yep.